video, we'll cover how to download a First Data FD series terminal. Before we begin, you will want to make sure you have your download ID as well as the URL and port number the server you'll be downloading from. We're going to be starting this download from the main idle sales screen. However, there are other screens you may be starting this download from, so the process will we will eventually catch up with where you may be on your screen now. If you are at the main idle sales screen, you will press the Enter and 4 buttons at the same time. The terminal will prompt for a password. The default password on this device is 990712, and Enter. For some devices, that password may be different. Another common password is 766130. Enter that, press Enter, and that should bring you to a new menu with options of Perform Download, Reboot Terminal, and Exit to OS. In this case, we're going to go to Exit to OS. We'll prompt this for the password a second time. So again, it's 990712, and Enter. And we'll give us a series of options. We're going to select Download, so you can either press Download on the screen, or you can press the number 1 key, and that's going to take us into the Download menu. We're going to start by editing the port information, so we'll press 1 for port, or you'll press port on the screen. And this will give us different communication types. We're going to do the download over the internet, so we are going to choose number 4, IP. However, if you're going to use this to do a download over the phone line, you can select 1, and the only real difference is it's going to prompt you for a phone number instead of prompting you for the IP address information, and then it'll step you through the process the same way. So we're going to select 4 for IP. It's going to ask us to enter the IP address and port number. In this case, we have a URL, and we already have it in here. For most devices, this information should already be in here and be correct. However, if you do need to change it, I'm going to walk you through just typing in the end of this address so you know how to do that. In order to get a period, we're going to press the alpha key 3 times, and then the number is 0. As you can see on the number 0, right there on the third place, is a dot. For the letter C, we would press alpha 3 times, so that corresponds to the location of the C on the number 2 button. And we press number 2, and we would get a C. For O, we'll press alpha 3 times, and 6. And for M, alpha 1 time, and 6. And then go ahead and press Enter. It will then prompt you to save. So we will say 4 for save, or you can click the save button there on the screen. The next option we'll go into is option 2 here, which is file. So we'll press the number 2 button. This is where you will enter in your download ID. And again, some download IDs will have letters in them, and we'll do that the same way as you did with the URL. You'll use that alpha key to count the digit on a certain button. So again, if you need the letter B, you press alpha twice, you press the number 2, you get the letter B. The APN and F name and R key should already be set correctly. So unless your processor tells you to change those, you're just going to leave them as their default configuration. So once your terminal ID is entered, you will press Enter. And then we'll go ahead and select 3 for run. You'll notice there are two other options down there at the bottom for RAM and CCV. Again, these will stay defaulted unless you are otherwise told to do so by your processor. But for 99% of the time, you're just going to go straight into run, which is going to begin that download. Once the terminal is connected, it will download all the data, it will reboot, extract all that data, and install it. Probably after another couple reboots, the terminal will bring you to your main idle sales screen, and you're ready to run a test transaction.